Hello friends, welcome to Walkie Talkies. So are you guys missing the aroma of freshly baked biscuits at home? Are you? I am not, because I can bake those biscuits at home. So today in this video I am going to share very easy Jeera biscuit recipes with you all. To learn that, you have to give me few likes, 500 likes for this video. Share my channel with others, subscribe my channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon. So let's begin with the recipe. For making Jeera biscuits, the ingredients are
1 cup of plain flour means maida, 1/4 cup of powdered sugar, 1 teaspoon salt, 1 tablespoon cumin seeds and 1.5 cup of unsalted butter. You can use ghee and refined oil also. I am using homemade unsalted butter. If you are using salted butter like Amul or any other brand, you need 1/2 teaspoon of salt. So let's begin with the roasting of the cumin seeds. So for that you need to put your oven on fast preheating mode. Fast preheating mode at 180 degrees Celsius and let's wait. In the meantime, we will mix our sugar and butter properly. Here I am using a mixing bowl. I'll add my butter into it. And I'll add sugar powder now and we'll mix it properly with
beater
the
over here. You can use powder. So I have to blend it till it gets fluffy.
So it's done now and it's already been 1.5 minutes. So let's check whether they have mixed properly or not. Or it should be fluffy also. So let's check. So you can see it has become fluffy as we wanted. In the meantime, our fast preheating has already been done. We need to put our cumin seeds for roasting and let's put our cumin seeds in our oven and need a convection mode at 180 degrees Celsius. Mine is 250 again, the highest one. I'll put it at 180 degree and for 4 to 5 minutes. So after 5 minutes my cumin seeds are roasted and it's hot, so I am using a glove. You need to be very careful while handling it. I'll crush it with my rolling pin. I'm not using grinder over here because I do not need a powder form. I need a semi-crushed form. So I'm using a rolling pin. This is how we need it. Semi-crushed form. It will give a nice aroma to your biscuit and it's reminding me of the bakery biscuits, you know. Wow. So now we will divide it into two parts, 3/4 tablespoon for mixing into our dry ingredients and 1/4 tablespoon for sprinkling over the biscuits. Now I'll add my dry ingredients into my wet ingredients. I'll add a little bit of plain flour first, then I'll add salt. Now I'm adding salt and 3/4 tablespoon of cumin, roasted cumin seeds. It will give a nice aroma to your biscuits. You can use ajwain also instead of cumin seeds. Now I'll add the leftover plain flour into my wet ingredient. So let's mix it properly with the spatula first and then we need to knead a soft dough for the Jeera biscuits. So let's knead it. So like this, you have to press it and make a very soft dough. So my dough is ready and it's very soft. So what we need to do is we need to, you know, roll it on a plain surface and cut it with a cookie cutter. So if you do not have cookie cutter, as I do not have, I am using a smidget over here. And this is a Tupperware smidget basically, and it's a square shape. I like square shape for the cookies, so I'm using it. If you want any other shape, you can use like a heart shape or a circle shape. So let's sprinkle a little bit of plain flour on a plain surface and we need to be very careful while rolling it. You have to be very gentle and soft. Do not handle it like a chapati dough. It's not like that. It's very soft, so you have to press with your hands the cracks on the corners and then sprinkle a little bit of plain flour and then again roll it. So we have to roll it, we have to press it like this and we have to roll the circle till the time we get a thickness of, not the circumference, we need a thickness of almost 0.5 centimeters. We can call it 1/4 inches. So roll it till then and be gentle, be soft with your soft dough. So yeah, this is how we knead it. And see, my 1.5 centimeter is ready. My and now I'll use my cookie cutter to cut it. You can use any shape, as I told you before also, but you know, this square shape cookies looks totally like a bakery product. So now I'll remove the extra part and I'll repeat the process again. So I am greasing my tray. You can use a glass tray also. I'm using a convection mode tray. It came with my microwave only. So this dough is the leftover dough, and I'll repeat the same process with it again. And now we need a knife to remove those cookies from the surface and put it into the tray. So this is how I'll put it into the tray. Very careful, very gentle. So press it again, roll it again, and do the same process and cut with your cookie cutter. And till the time the whole dough, whatever is left with you, is finished with your cookie cutter, you have to use it. So this is how my cookies are, you know, in the tray now. And I'll sprinkle little bit of leftover, that 1/4 tablespoon of cumin seeds, roasted cumin seeds. This will give, you know, a nice color also, and feel of bakery baked biscuits. So now, and you can, you know, you can use ajwain also, as I told you before. So with the same recipe, you can use make two types of biscuit, one ajwain biscuits, one jeera biscuits. Now my tray is ready to go into the oven, and again we need to fast preheat at 180 degrees Celsius. So fast preheat, mine I have already done. It's 180 degrees Celsius already done. So now I'll put it at convection mode, again 180 degrees Celsius convection mode. So see, this is convection mode now, 180 degree, and for 20 minutes we will do it. So I'll use a steel rack over here. What it does is, it gives you your cookies a nice brown color. It helps in giving a you need not to turn it over again for cooking it from both the sides, and it will give a very, very nice brown color to your cookies. So now you can see my cookies are ready, and I need it this much brown, and it's crispy also, cooked from both the sides. See, you can see, and it's very hot. And if you want, you know, if you want more brown color into this, you have to do convection mode 160 degree for 4 to 5 minutes. So it will become more brown. So my cookies are ready, and you can use wheat flour also in place of plain flour. You can use ajwain in place of jeera, cumin seed. So same recipe and 2-in-1 biscuits. So let's enjoy it. I'm going to eat it with my coffee. Now you enjoy it with your tea, or you know, wow, I'm going to eat it, yummy. So if you like it, please like my channel, share, subscribe, and bye bye. Thank you.